new group of big people and little people, to teach you more about the Lord. So, looks like I see some empty chairs. You know what? You could bring some friends from your neighborhood next week that come to Sunday school and then come to Caraway Street so that they can hear. That would be a good idea. I think they'll like it too. Okay, well, let's see. These little people live over there in the doors, and some little people live in these boxes. Let's see if somebody's over here. I'm sure they'd like to meet me. Egbert, are you over here?
Hey, Chris. I'm over here.
Hi, Egbert.
Hi.
How you doing?
Pretty good.
Oh, you got a new tie on today.
Sure did.
Boy, that looks really nice with that sweater and that shirt. Are you ready to go?
Yep.
Okay, well, you go get ready. We're going to start in just a minute.
I will.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
That's Egbert. He wouldn't like to study and read books and do stuff like that instead of playing football and baseball and stuff like that. Can you imagine? Oh, well, some kids are like that. That's good. He lives on the street, and he's going to be here every other week. So that was Egbert. I wonder if Gertrude's over here. Let's see if she is. Maybe she's way down here. Gertrude, come out and meet everybody.
I'm over here!
Oh, there you are. Well, hi, Gertie. Come out here a little more. Let's see what's on your chest. Who knows what this letter is? Raise your hand if you know. What is it?
G.
It's a G. Who thinks they know what the G might stand for?
God.
Could be God. Does the G stand for God, Gertrude?
No.
Oh, what's it stand for?
Gertrude!
Of course. Sometimes we have initials on our stuff. Okay, that's a nice monogram. It's very jazzy.
Thank you.
We're going to teach them a verse today. What was, where was it found, do you remember?
John 15:9.
John 15:9. Okay, well, thanks for telling us. See you later.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Okay, let's see if Rudy's over here. Rudy! Are you down here?
Rudy. I'm here, Chris.
I can't get this right. Hi, Rudy.
Hi, Chris.
How are you today?
Fine, thanks.
Would you look at this great bunch of kids we've got out here? Aren't
wow.
they special?
Yes.
Boy, we're going to get going pretty soon, but don't I smell something cooking?
Yes, we're baking cookies.
Ooh, what kind?
Chocolate chip.
Mmm, no. Uh-oh, they smell kind of hot. Don't let them burn. Go get them.
Okay.
Okay. Ooh. Just let them burn. Well, I'd give up on the boxes. Maybe Lucinda's over here on the door.
Lucinda! Come out, wherever you are. Thank you for all you've given us. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, who would like to
this group, but he's real sick today. You might, if you think about it, pray for him because he's got a real high temperature. So I'm going to do his part today, but almost every week he will be here with the others, okay? You have a question, honey? He is. Well, you probably know he was sick when you came today, didn't you? Okay, now we're ready for the first part of Caraway
Okay, the four of us are going to come out and ask you a question.
three straight back.
Okay.
Here.
Okay.
answer is that God's word, it comes from God's word, the Bible, where it says in 1 John 4:8, he that doesn't love doesn't know God, for God is love. Thanks, kid.
I have loved you.
20 minutes before dinner. Mom makes some cookies this afternoon, and she put them in the cookie jar, but she told me I should not touch them. But I was real hungry, and just one cookie would have mattered. So when she was in the bedroom, I went in and took a cookie and ate it. But then I got to feeling real bad about it, so I went to her and I told her that I had done that. Does anybody know what the C word is now in the blue? C, no? It has a sound, but it doesn't start with a C. What? No? Oh, that starts with an S. Okay. Oh, good. She got it.
Great.
See, that I was thinking of is confess. You know, if I told my mom that I took the cookie, that would be confessing to her I did. Do you know that God wants us to tell him when we have done wrong things? That's what confess means, and that's a C that we need to learn about. Okay. Another word I'm thinking of starts with a B. Has something to do with something about Jesus that we're learning about. Okay, it starts with a B.
Oh,
huh? Baptized. Baptized, that's a good one, not the one I'm thinking of. Jerry, do you have another one?
No.
Okay, in the back row?
Pile.
Well, that was a good one, not the one I'm thinking of.
Believe.
Great, okay. What are things we have to believe about Jesus? He was a real good man, right? He just walked on the earth and he died and that was all.
No.
Is that right?
No.
No, tell me some things we need to believe. Okay, what do we need to believe about Jesus? That's who we're particularly talking about. Okay, that's right. Okay, that he is our Savior. Okay, what did he do for us? Give me more specifics.
Did he die for us?
He died on the cross, and then he stayed dead.
No.
No, what else? He came back to life again. How many days later, everybody?
Three
days later. Okay, do you know what? Something else happened when he died on the cross. If you don't have Jesus in your life, now listen real carefully, all eyes up here. This is very important, all eyes right up here. All eyes, please. All eyes, please. All eyes, please, right here. Okay, if you don't have Jesus in your life, there is something inside you called the old me that forces you to do things your own way, which don't please Jesus. But do you know what? When Jesus comes into your life, he kills that thing that forces you to do things that are wrong and gives you a choice. So besides Jesus dying on the cross, Galatians 2:20 says that he killed the thing inside of you that forces you to do things wrong. Right now, if Jesus is in your life, you don't have to choose to punch your brother if he punches you back. Did you know that? Some kids just feel like they just can't stop it. But if Jesus is inside you, he's stronger than the thought that I'm going to punch him back or I'm going to disobey mom. This is a big topic, and we're going to talk a lot more about it in Caraway Street. But the old me died on the cross, too, okay? So we confessed we've done wrong things. Anybody not done wrong things? I've done wrong things.
I've done
good. Have you? Good girl. Way to admit that. That's great. Okay. B is believe. Lots of things about Jesus, we just said. And the third one has three little letters in it and starts with A. Something about Jesus again. Something about how we get him to be a part of our life. Okay?
Ask.
Great. Okay, we have to ask him to come in. He's not automatically there just because you read your Bible or just because you go to church or just because your mom and dad love you, is it? You have to invite him like a friend into your life. Okay? If you have not done that today, you are not a Christian, is what we call you. But if you have done it, then we are all part of the same family. If any boy or girl has not asked Jesus to come into their life, please stay for just a few minutes after Caraway Street today, and we would love to introduce you to our very best friend.
Do you think we've enjoyed his coming?
Okay? All right, those are the CBAs of salvation. I think we're about ready for the second half of Caraway Street. 15:9, I have loved you even as the Father has loved
are Numbers and Deuteronomy. Can you say them along with me?
Jesus.
paper, just keep your hand up and you'll get one.
I got one.
You cannot use Big Bird. Do not use Big Bird.
We have a couple here.
Buddy still have her paper?
Okay. We'll take care of it.
Listen. One more thing he has to say to us.
I'm so excited. I'm in all my feathers.
Take it easy. We don't want you to be a ball bird.
Ball bird.
My word. Look at this. the big inning. Good. Yeah. face chagrined. He was nervous about what was he going to ask her. He knows. Think about it a second. He was real nervous and he didn't know what, he was afraid to ask her to what? No help?
Be a friend.
One more. Be what? No help. Turn around this way.
You're not helping.
Be a friend, but be a little more than friendly.
Love.
Yeah, Valentine, right? Okay. Obey them. Tell me one way you might obey them. Ooh, that's a good one. You hear that? All these moms and dads love that. If you're
you that you love us and you're going to give us a wonderful day. We praise you for it. Show us a friend that we can invite to come with us next week. In Jesus' name, amen.
Don't get up.
Oh, yeah.
In the strike fix right here. Okay, next Sunday, gang, remember, next Sunday we will have Caraway only at night. It will start next Sunday at night, so you have to come at night to come to Caraway. It won't be in the morning anymore until September. Okay, so it's, you bring your parents.
Which he has commissioned and called us to go forth in the marketplace of this township, county, and state, and even to the uttermost parts of the earth for some of us. So may it come to pass, our Lord, as we look further into this portion of thy word. In Jesus' name we ask. Amen. Let's stand together. Tonight, four of our young people are going to give testimony, personal testimony, of having received Christ as Savior and Lord through one of the two testimonies appointed by our Lord for his people on earth, that of believers' baptism. We'll begin the service with those testimonies right at 6 o'clock. I trust you won't miss. This is always a very delightful and blessed time for us as a church family. We will then look into portions of the word tonight concerning the matter of bodily healing. In the Gospels and in the Acts, having just finished our study of James 5, 13 through 20, I want us to consider also, and I want to attach to this as an addendum, what the Scriptures teach concerning bodily healing as recorded in the Gospels and in the Acts. And I trust that you'll be here with us to enjoy further that study of that glorious truth. May I say that for those of you who prayed a moment ago and were promoted from the ranks of the rebellious into the ranks of the righteous, I have a Bible study that I'd love to put into your hands. I'll be out at the door with Lois. We'll be there, and if you'll just ask for it, I'll be glad to give it to you. All you need is the Bible and a pencil and a little study. It's to firm up the foundation for you in this most important of all decisions. We're kind of a joy and a privilege to put the study in your hands. You take it home, and you work it there. It's got a big red one on the front of it. When you finish with this one, we'll give you two, which you can't have two, you do one. All right? Good. Let's bow together for his benediction. Now to him who is able to keep us from stumbling and to present us blameless before his presence with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be the glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. Amen.
Oh, how he loves you and me. Diligence to participate in that which God has provided.
And if you aren't or won't, then you're not. Say, tell me, when they look at you tomorrow in the shop, and listen to you as well, in the shop, on the line, in the office, in the neighborhood, in your home, or in the marketplace, what are they going to see? What are they going to see? Just another one of the herd? Or will they see a well-dressed Christian? One who's allowed the Spirit of God to dress them up in this glorious garment, which is none other than Jesus Christ, the likeness of Jesus Christ, taking on his likeness. It's a cliche, which I know you've heard, but it's most apropos at this point. The only gospel some people read is the gospel according to you and me. What is the gospel according to you and me? Let's pray. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Each of us shut up unto our Lord. Have you been complacent, indifferent, passive in this matter of being of Christian growth, being well-dressed for your Lord? Tell him about it, will you? Just agree with him right now. And then tell him that you're purposing by his enablement, that from this moment on, to let him dress you up in all the aspects of this garment, so that from henceforth you're a well-dressed child of God. Will you tell him that and mean it? Nothing would mean more to the heart of your Father in heaven than this. A baby when it's born is a thing of beauty and delight, but if it does not grow, it becomes a real heartache. How does our Father in heaven? What are his feelings towards you and me? Are we a thing of delight and joy? Or are we a heartache to him? How sick you, my brothers and sisters? Oh, our loving Heavenly Father, we are thankful that we have a Father in heaven. It's who is so long-suffering, so loving, so gracious, so kind, so generous to we who are so unworthy and at times so unlovable and so unlike the children of thy family. The likeness is very light. It's hardly discernible. But we're thankful that we have a Father to whom we can look, who is longing that it be otherwise, that there be a clear distinction in our manner of living. Our Father, we look to thee to give us the strength and the wherewithal to consistently be found doing these things. In the strength of our Lord, we can't do it in ourselves, but we have the strength in us to do it. To allow thee by thy power to dress us up in this garment and to love wearing it. That we may multiply further glory to thy name only, but also be a blessing and a channel to a lost and perishing world all around us. An instrument in thine hands to rescue many yet from perishing. May this be the longing and the decision, the commitment of our lives from this day forth. In Jesus' name we ask it all. Amen. Let's stand together. 2:30. This lovely instrument is going to be used to the glorifying of our Lord, and thus we are going to set it apart officially as a family for the furtherance of the praise and glory of our Lord with Mrs. Doris Steinhardt at the console. I trust that you'll be here. It will only last for 1 hour. We'll have you on your way back home by 3:30 so that you do not miss tonight. It's another meeting of the stockholders. We're going to get a report on another one of our big investments that we've had down in Brazil. I'm sure you'd like to know, you know, what the Lord's been doing. And thus we can further rejoice in the wise investment that you have been making there for your Lord. Let's bow together for his benediction. Now unto him who is able to keep us from stumbling and to present us blameless before his presence with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be the glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. Amen.